We're going to begin by using a black eyeliner pencil. We're going to use this just to outline the shape of the mask in the way that you want. This is much more easy to wipe off than liquid liner. So if you make any mistakes, feel free to use a Q-tip or makeup remover and start over. To give the mask some interest, I'm using some dips and curves that give it an untraditional shape. So use your creativity to make a shape in which reflects you. Now we're going to use a liquid liner. I'm going to finish the shapes that are half done in the center of my nose. And then I'll go on to go over the eyeliner outline that we had just made with the liquid liner. Now I'm mirroring the other side of my face, which I've already completed. However, you can fill in the mask with any shapes that you want to. I primarily am sticking to curved lines, dots, circles, and swirls. These are the shapes that I chose to fill in the mask with, but again, feel free to fill it in with whatever you want. It is nice to add some smaller details to the mask on the outside rather than just the inside, so feel free to add dots and little swirls around the outline of the mask because it makes it more interesting and allows the mask to really become part of your face rather than a single shape. Here I am doing everything symmetrical. However, if you feel the need to add anything on one side than the other, you get a creative vibe and you just want to try something new, go ahead. People really aren't going to notice if one thing is different from one side than the other side because there is so much detail within this look. We're first going to prime the lid, but we are going to take a really deep and rich gold eyeshadow and apply this all over the lid. Next, we're going to take a really gorgeous olive green and apply this in a wing shape to the outer edge of the lid. We're going to take a light earthy brown shimmer and apply this just above the olive green, keeping that wing shape moving upwards towards the brow. Now we're going to take a light neutral white shimmer and just fill in just under the brow and blend in with the other colors. Take the same liquid liner which you were using for the mask and create a dramatic winged look. The wing look that I chose to create today is much more square than it is pointed. So just take a look and notice the thickness of the line and the way in which I draw it upwards towards the tip of the green eyeshadow. We're going to curl our lashes and apply your favorite mascara. As always, focusing on the outer lashes to create a butterfly effect, you're also going to apply this mascara to your lower lashes. Next, we're going to use a very deep blush. We're going to apply this just under the edge of the mask, really focusing on the skin of your face where it meets the hairline, blending out to create a really dramatic, nice pink contouring effect. Now we're going to use a dramatic pink lip stain, but first prep your lips with just some chapstick and then go ahead and apply the lip stain so the color isn't as bright as it would be without the chapstick. Once you have done this, your masquerade look is complete.